something cool. So why don't we make some fruit ice pops? Compared to grocery and store-bought ice cream and ice popsicles, which are totally loaded with artificial sugars and sweeteners, homemade ice pops are sweetened by the natural fruit sugars, making it a healthier alternative. It is also delicious, refreshing, but most of all, it's easy to make. Let's get to it! Ice pops are really versatile. You can actually put any flavor combination that you want and switch it around. But today, I'll be showing you a strawberry and mango one and chocolate banana. So for our first flavor, for the strawberry and mango, we have to wash the strawberries and remove its stem. Wow. Now, we go to our mangoes, which we have to dice. Super magic. Now we're gonna need a blender. Here's your blender. And now, time to put our fruits in. Simply put in all our mangoes into the pot. Our strawberries and our yogurt, which is around a cup. We're gonna blend this until it has a smooth consistency. We need our molds. I bought these molds from a Japanese dollar store for around 90 pesos, so you can also visit them to get one for yourself. Now we're gonna put our mixture inside the pops. So we're gonna reserve the other two for our other flavor, the banana chocolate one. So for now, I'm just gonna fill the two. Make sure that you don't fill the whole thing up and only around like 3/4 to make space because it's gonna freeze and expand. And then we put in the cap. Let's clean up our blender and on to the next flavor. For the chocolate banana, it's really simple. We only need 3 ingredients. For the first step, we need to slice 2 bananas. Ooh! Now we put everything in the blender. The banana, the chocolate powder, and yogurt. Our bananas. 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder. And 1/2 cup of yogurt. Like before, we're gonna blend until it has a smooth consistency. A little bit too thick, I'm gonna add around 1/4 cup of low-fat milk. Now we put it inside the mold. Now we have to put our molds inside the freezer for at least 6 hours, but ideally overnight. For easier removal, it's better to wash the molds a little bit first to pop it across.